seeing me fall under pressure. They ain't never ever seen me fall, nah, never. Always keep on up on them cause I'm too clever. I will never ever sell my soul, nah, never.
Now I'm getting excited. Hello, YouTube. I'm currently in Kentucky. Why am I in Kentucky, you might be asking? Because I am currently at the Midwest Institute for Sexuality and Gender Diversity. And I'm really excited. This is my second year being here. I don't know how many conferences they've had. Last year's conference was in Ohio. So I'm really excited to be here in Kentucky. And I'm also excited to vlog it because this is also sponsored by my institution where I'm getting my higher education. So of course I could do this on my own time, but this is technically my last year. So I'm really excited to fully embrace it and the fun experience and all the things that I learned about myself in last year. I'm ready to be like more confident in my identity and courageous to speak in these rooms that I'm at this year. And now I'm gonna keep the fit. I just love this fit. It makes me really comfy. I'm just gonna throw on some earrings and do my hair a bit. Just some edge work, ponytail, probably do a high bun instead of a low bun. Okay, totally unrelated, but yes. Anything's related in a vlog. The whole idea of a vlog is TMI, so you're gonna get a whole lot of unrelated information, but yes. Session one, substance use disorders in LGBTQA communities. Now, mind you, each session has about 7 to 10 workshops. So you have to choose between 7 to 10 workshops. This is very hard, but I wrote these all down. So just, again, session one, and they're all gonna be at different sessions. Sessions 1 through 3 are all on Saturday, and session 4 is on Sunday. And this conference is held Friday through Sunday. So tonight is just like the opening night. We have some amazing keynote speakers, and I'm just really excited to bring you all with me and experience this with me. So and I'm gonna probably rewatch this video for the rest of my life. As somebody that was literally struggling in their identity and their sexual identity, and to like just be so proud and at a conference with other affirming college students and staff members is just so beautiful. Okay, session one, substance use disorders in LGBTQA plus communities. Session two, count it all joy, Black LGBT plus in history. Session three, queer and trans, indigenous and pre-colonial cultures. Or I might go to for fuck's sake, and I didn't write the rest of it. But it sounds very interesante, so we are deciding which one of those two. And then session four, queer art talk with Keith Herring. We are gonna do our hair, we're gonna do an updo, do our edges, throw on some jewelry, and welcome to the conference. Today is Saturday, and I did not get back to you guys. I'm also in a cafe, and I just made the decision to buy a journal. I have so many journals. I think I have more journals than I have books. I'm my own book. I am buying this journal because I'm using it. Definitely had to justify this purchase as the new journal in the outline of my memoir, which we decided on because yesterday was so epic. Once I get out of this cafe, I'll give you guys some more input on the first day. But today is about to get started though. Yesterday, during the keynote speaker, she loves animals. She got so emotional about a dog that was, I believe, deaf and blind that she wanted to adopt. She's just so beautiful. Okay, anyway. Hayden Crystal. She's also a comedian. I was so inspired. Like, just do it. So just do it. And so it was a Q&A session. So I asked, I said, if you could have any comedian open for you a characteristic, would you want them to have? And she jokingly was like, less funny than me. She was just like telling me, if you want to be a comedian, go for it. She's like, are you a comedian? I was like, at heart. And she's like, go for it. I was like, yeah. We made it. Then I asked that question, which I totally did for the plot of my life, because I'm the main character. And then she was just like, are you a comedian? And I was like, at heart. And then she was like, man, start doing stuff, build up your resume, do all these things. She's like, I don't plan on being in Chicago, but if I ever am in Chicago, contact me and bring up this conversation. And I was like, and I was just so excited. I was proud of myself that I'm even at this beautiful conference, that I had the courage to come to this conference, the courage to ask the question, and the courage to now just do and be all the things I want to be, which I know is going to be a constant cycle,
But that was one thing she said as well. She's like, let this weekend replenish you. And I'm allowing that to happen. And it's been so nice to get my cup filled up again. So we just left. My first session, yes, with substance abuse disorder. It was so helpful to, like, one, to know the reasons behind why someone can have an abuse disorder, know what the person's going through while having an abuse disorder, and knowing the resources and how to support someone that is recovering. So it was great. 10 out of 10 recommend. That was our first session. And she was, I expected it to be like this real serious conversation, but she made it so relaxed and she normalized it in a way that's like, this is a part of our lives. This is hard, but here are some solutions. So it was great. 10 out of 10. Our next session is Black History, Queer Black History. And then this amazing fucking, this is a program that is for queer leadership. I think that's really cool. Okay, I'm learning so much. So excited. And I just bought a journal. I'm such a journal. I have more journals on my desk than books, but collectively I have both, a lot of both. And I'm really excited though about this journal because I have a really specific purpose for it. And I got some bookmarks. I did need more bookmarks. Okay, I've actually had a lot of self-control as far as finances on this trip, which I'm really excited about. Yeah, session two, Count It All Joy, Black LGBTQ plus in history. So I'm really excited. As a Black woman, I do not know the history. Of course, I know Black history, but not queer Black history. So I'm excited to learn more about that. I'll keep you all updated. After that amazing speech, I'm like, you know what? I'm on vacation. I'm going to have a great weekend. I'm going to do all the things. So it was really nice. Me and my buddies, we all went like swimming, walked around downtown. And it's been really great. Went to bed at 2 a.m. Luckily, I'm a morning person because I don't know. But anyway, I got up at 7 and I was able to get ready for the day. And I'm really excited. Got pumped up with coffee as well. And that was the best part about the keynote speaker and the person that was interviewing her, is that they were both students before the conference. That's so, so cool. And I would love to come back and serve this conference and this community of beautiful individuals. Oh, and the theme this year is so cute. Queer joy as our lasting legacy. We have come to the last and final day of this conference, and it has been so amazing to just learn from others. So quick recap. So I did go to the third session, which was called For Fuck's Sake, and it just talked about like queer pleasures, and it doesn't even have to necessarily belong to the queer community, but they just talked about, like, I personally didn't know the difference between kink fetish, dominism, and stuff, like just learning those correct definitions. They even talked about vanilla sex, all the fun things. And then we also went to a session this morning about Keith Haring, the artist that did a lot of like political art and also was diagnosed with AIDS and soon died by AIDS, but between the point when they got diagnosed and before they died, they created so much beautiful art. And so it's very interesting because I was at Urban Outfitters yesterday and I kept seeing some of his symbols on shirts and stuff, and I'm like, what is this? Like, I really caught my attention. And then to go into the session today and be like, oh wow, so I'm low-key gonna have to go back and go get that shirt. And I was in the clearance line. Yes. It's been an amazing conference. I learned so much about myself and others in like such a positive way, self-development, and like even just be in this community where I'm open to like think about these things in a safe space. And yesterday I went to a forum called Queer and Faith, which is so nice just to hear about everybody's different experiences. I don't know why I'm like always thinking it's like Christians that struggle with this, but like even hearing people that identify with Hinduism, Judaism, and all the different types of faith and like coming out as queer. Some people never had to struggle, and both of their parents were priests, so they didn't even know homophobia was a thing. And so it was just nice to just hear everyone's different experiences. And yeah, so we're about to get lunch and hit the road, I believe 7-hour drive. Thank you so much for watching and coming along with me on this amazing trip, this amazing vlog, Mbltacc 2023, Lexington, Kentucky. And it's already said that next year the next conference will be in Marquette, Michigan. So if you're interessante about that, I don't even think that's the past tense of interesting Spanish. But anyway, if you found this vlog interesting, and or any parts of it resonated with you, please make sure or see if like you're interested in going. I believe it'll be in the month of October next year, so definitely look out for that for 2024 if you're interested. And thank you so much for watching. If anything resonated or you simply enjoyed it, please do not be shy with the like, comment, or subscribe buttons. And we live this life but not for long, so I'm gonna be what I want when I want. Yeah,
we live this life but not for long, so I'm gonna be what I want when I want when I want. Yeah, I'm gonna do what I want when I want when I want. Yeah, I'm going hard till I'm gone, till I'm gone, till I'm gone.